morning and welcome to Living Local 15. I'm your host, Jessica Williams. Thank you so much for joining me. It's time to grab a cup of your favorite Joe and enjoy the show. Today, I am taking you inside of the dance studio of the Fort Wayne Ballet. This professional dance company has several performances throughout the year, including their Valentine's-inspired show, Love Notes, happening this weekend. And later, the nonprofit organization From This Day Forward joins me in studio to explain how their event planning ministry works. That and more happening now.
Fashion, food, and fun. You're watching Living Local 15 with your host, Jessica Williams.
I'm at the Fort Wayne Ballet, surrounded by beautiful professional dancers. Today, we will learn about the upcoming Love Notes performance and get a sneak peek. Joining me now is their artistic director, Karen Gibbons Brown. Hi, Karen.
Hi, Jessica.
How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
Doing so well. And this is such an exciting time for the ballet.
I know
that you all just came off of your holiday performances. And
right.
Now that it's February, you have your special Valentine's Day presentation. So tell us all about Love Notes.
Love Notes. It's an ensemble or repertoire performance of pieces that all have something to do with love. Love of family, love of another person, love triangles, adorable love, young love. It's just all about the community and love.
Yeah, which is so great. And I saw your show last year, and it was so wonderful. So many pieces. So you were fully entertained, something
great
for everyone, which is great. And this year, you have a new performance hall that you are moving to.
We are. We're performing in the Arts Lab, the Black Box, as we call it here.
Yes.
But the Parkview Arts Lab here on our campus, the Arts campus. And then we're taking this on the road to both Wabash, the Eagle Theater, and then we'll be in Auburn at the Auburn Core Duesenberg Museum.
Yes. Oh, that's a wonderful facility, too. Wow.
Yes. We're excited about it. It's great that we've grown.
Yes, you have, because last year there were two performances.
Correct.
Now you have five.
Right.
So that's awesome. And where you will be this year, that sound stage kind of black box room is so intimate. So it's going to be so cool to see these performances kind of presented there.
Up close and personal.
Yes.
And the whole thing for the dancers is they have to take their focus a little bit differently than you would in a larger theater.
Mm-hmm.
So that's one of the things we've been working on. But you can buy a VIP table
and
sit seriously right with the dancers or a little further back in a seat.
Yeah, and you kind of have this whole ambiance of the night. Couples can come and have their little exclusive table. So tell me about the ticket structure and what people can expect when they come.
All right, so you can have a general admission ticket, which is sitting in the seat slightly behind the tables, and that is first come, first serve for seating, with the ticket, of course.
Yeah.
And then the VIP tables are tables for two, and they get wine, flowers, and chocolates.
Oh, that's so nice.
We actually had a marriage proposal at one of these one time.
Really?
It was really exciting.
Oh, that is so special. And the perfect way to really celebrate the holiday, or just really coming off of the colder days, getting out and about in the community. This is such a great performance. Okay, so four performances this upcoming weekend.
Well, three, yes.
Okay, three this upcoming
Friday
weekend.
Friday night, Saturday night, and a Sunday matinee. And that's the new one.
Okay.
And then, as I said, we're on the road next Tuesday and Wednesday.
Okay, going to different locations. And as people kind of just understand how this ballet is structured and how you all work so hard, I always get fascinated to hear about your professional dancers.
Right.
So give us an overview of that structure.
Absolutely. We have an academy, and we train lovely young people to be either doctors or dancers or whatever their life choice is.
Yeah.
But then we have this professional company, and they come to us from all over the world. It's an ensemble of about 22 dancers, and they come to us literally, not just America, but I think you have a few behind us. They're working on a piece with our ballet master, Robert LaFosse.
Yes.
So this is their 30 weeks a year they're with us. They live in Fort Wayne, they work in Fort Wayne, and present this wonderful artistic presentation.
Yeah, and as I walked in, I'm like, oh, so many familiar faces,
oh, that's
favorite
great.
Dancers from the past couple of years. So that's so wonderful to see them again. And I'm so excited about this performance. So if someone wants to get tickets, where should they go?
We have the Arts Tix through the Arts United ticketing platform. And you can go online to either select your seat or reserve a table.
Okay, well, wonderful. And we have a special preview to show you all, a little sneak peek of what to expect from this performance. And so what will we show today?
Today is a sneak peek of a piece called Remembrance, choreographed by our ballet master, Robert LaFosse. I think you'll see him in the workings of all of this. And he has come to us from New York for the season and has a very broad career of his own, quite exciting career. But he choreographed this especially for our dancers. And so it's a trio. And it's about someone from your past and letting go of that to find someone in your future.
Ooh, okay, here's Remembrance.
Thank you.
Karen, that piece was so beautiful. Like, it was so emotional. It, I don't know, it was so captivating and really drew in the audience.
Great.
So exciting to see that on the stage this upcoming weekend. So thank you so much for sharing a preview and talking with me today.
Always a pleasure to have you here. Thanks so much.
And if you would like more information about the Fort Wayne Ballet, we'll have their website listed below to get your tickets, and we'll be right back.
Have an idea for the show? Want to find out how you can be a guest? Contact us at livinglocal15@wayne.com.
Do you want to know the best places to go to eat and drink around Northeast Indiana? Well, join me, Jessica Williams, for Living Local 15, weekdays at 9 a.m. as I take you inside of the best restaurants, new and old, explore their menu, and of course, mix up some cocktails. Where will I go next? Well, you'll have to watch and see, but I want to know, where do you recommend I go?
Keep up with Jessica Williams on Living Local 15, weekdays at 9.
From This Day Forward is a local nonprofit organization that strives to demonstrate the power of Christ's love by educating, encouraging, and mentoring those in need as they celebrate life events. Here today to tell us more about her business is Heather Krimple. Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. Thank you.
Yes.
Excited to be here.
Excited to have you.
Yeah.
Because your organization sounds so interesting because you offer services. A variety of services that people may not have heard of. So give us an overview.
Yeah, so we are unique. We're kind of defining the terms of an events ministry per se. So we offer planning assistance for those that maybe are planning some sort of special event like a wedding, birthday, graduation, vow renewal. We've even helped with memorials before. But we help just connect to other vendors if they're kind of lost in that process or just there to help with whatever questions they might have. And then we also offer decor rental. We have an entire warehouse full of items, a variety of items that you can rent out. And then we also have a boutique in the Huntertown area that offers gently used formal wear, shoes, jewelry, at really affordable prices. We're very passionate about, let's celebrate that special day, but please don't go into debt to do that.
Yeah, which is great. So that supplement support, rather, you don't really hear so much about that, especially in the way of ministry, which is serving the community. So what made you create this concept?
So my husband is a worship leader, and he was serving at a church in Columbia City many years ago. And he had a young lady who was a foreign exchange student from Germany, and she was on his praise team. She graduated, went home, but was coming back to visit her host family in the States and wanted a traditional American wedding. Yeah. Had no idea how to go about planning something, did not have the funds to do something. And then her host family, we watched them struggle and wrestle with, they felt like they didn't have adequate funds to do a traditional ceremony reception. So we had so much leftover stuff from our wedding. My mom and I love to just collect things in general, just you never know when you're gonna need them. So we helped her out with what we had, and just the genuine, humble gratefulness from them kind of sparked an idea.
Yeah.
We never thought it would be us doing it. We were both working full-time at the time, but God kept knocking on our hearts. And then after that, I got reacquainted with a childhood friend who, her future mother-in-law was diagnosed with stage 4 cancer. So they were moving everything up, trying to plan and also process the diagnosis and all of that. And so going through that experience, I'm like, oh my gosh, what do you do in that instance when you still want to celebrate because postponing is not an option sometimes, but then you thought you had several months to a year to plan and save. So that again sparked some more ideas. And then finally, my mom and I just said, you know what, God's saying, this is something we need to do. Let's do it. I have a background, I'm a theater major, mm-hmm. and then also have a background in special needs and teach therapeutic horseback riding lessons. So I am not a business person at all. So it was terrifying, terrifying. A lot of Googling and praying, and here we are.
Yes, so, well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah, I think that, you know, becoming a business person is just by practice, right?
Yeah, learned a lot. I have learned a lot.
Yes. And so how exactly does your business work as far as the services? Is this something that is completely complimentary, or is there just a fee involved, but it's less?
That's a great question. So the way our process works, if you're interested in any of our services like decor rental or planning assistance, we have an application on our website, just asks a couple questions to kind of tell us what's going on. Is this an emergency situation? Do you have a budget? Do you not have a budget? What kinds of items are you looking for? Because we do not have everything under the sun. We are not for everybody because we just cannot accommodate. I wish I had a million warehouses that I could just have everything. But we have a lot. And so what we do is we meet with each individual, kind of discuss what their needs are. What does budget look like? We usually ask for some form of service fee just because we would like our clients to have kind of some skin in the game too and be held accountable. It's not just a free ride, but it's very much individually based on circumstances and budget. And every once in a while, we do have someone where there is some crazy life challenges that there is no budget whatsoever. And that's where we like to build up our scholarship fund to be able to apply that and say, you know what? It's okay. Don't worry about it. Enjoy your day. Celebrate with your loved ones because oftentimes there's some craziness going on there. Someone's sick or someone's getting deployed suddenly. And so we'd really like the focus to be on the reason for the celebration versus stressing out, how am I going to pay for decorations? How am I going to pay for a dress? How am I going to, I got to put it on a credit card or take out a personal loan? And we, no, we don't want that.
Yeah.
All of our proceeds go right back in towards the organization. We are 100% volunteer driven. We do not have any paid staff. And as far as our boutique goes, anybody is welcome to shop in our boutique anytime during our regular hours. So please come see us.
Yes, absolutely. And you actually have an event coming up, your fashion show. So
We are super excited. It's called the Great Gown Makeover. We started it last year, so we had so much popular demand that we decided to do it this year, but put a spin on it with doing a fashion show. So we have about 21 vintage dresses, I guess you could say, or outdated dresses, but not vintage enough to be cool vintage, that we were trying to find a purpose for. So we decided, you know what? What if we give an opportunity for students, amateurs, and professionals in the community to take one of these gowns and completely redesign it into something new. And it does not have to be a wedding dress, just something wearable. So the dresses have been dispersed, and we have about 28 participants between students, professionals, amateurs, and some of them are on teams. We've partnered with the Carroll High School fashion and textiles class. So that is all going to get revealed. The final projects are going to get revealed in a fashion show format on March 9th. So we're super excited. It turned out so amazing, so creative, way beyond my abilities. we have such talent in our community, and we just want to showcase that. And then also hopefully spark some ideas of, just because something doesn't look like your vision right now, that you might be able to make some tweaks, reuse, repurpose, and recycle, and it can be even better than what you anticipated.
That sounds so cool. What a cool concept. It'll be exciting to see the final reveal for the dresses.
It's open to the public. Tickets are just $10, and it's a fundraiser for us as well, but come support these individuals, because it's going to be amazing. If it's anything like last year, we have even more participants this year and even more dresses this year. And it will be at Carroll High School this year.
Carroll High School. Okay. Well, thank you so much, Heather.
No problem.
It's been a joy to learn about your business.
Thank you.
And if you would like more information about From This Day Forward, we'll have their website listed below, and also check out their upcoming fashion show. We'll be right back.
Follow us on social media at Living Local 15. We'll be right back.
Wake up with us on Wayne 15's First News every weekday morning.
We'll bring you the local news you need to start your day.
Stay with CBS Mornings at 7 on Wayne 15.
We've got the overnight breaking news and in-depth reporting.
And uplifting stories to start your day off right.
Then at 9, watch Living Local 15 with Jessica Williams. Hey, Jessica.
We're talking food, fun, and everything going on in Northeast Indiana.
First News, CBS Mornings.
And then Living Local 15.
A great way to start your day.
Every day.
Thank you so much for tuning in today. And remember, you can always rewatch segments and episodes of Living Local 15 by going to wane.com, downloading the Wayne app, and checking us out on YouTube. And I'll leave you with this. It's never too late to live your best life, so start living it today. And I look forward to seeing you here tomorrow. Bye-bye.
Living Local 15, proudly driven by the Kelly Automotive Group.